Good morning, Huntington North. I'm Lillian Schottman.
And I'm Cindy Taylor, and this is HNHS Today for Wednesday, October 16th.
This Friday will be our first blood drive of the school year. Students who are 16 years old and who have signed up, please remember to turn in your signed parent consent form by the end of the day today.
Our very first improv night called Vike Drop will be held in the locker lunch night from 5 to 6 p.m. Enter through door 2. Doors will open at 4:30 and the cost is $1. Bring extra cash for water, snacks, or raffle ticket. Limited seating is available. If you have any questions, see Miss Denny, Miss Heidi, or Miss Wynn.
If you are trying out for the variety show, please sign up for a time on the sheet near room 217. If you are not able to attend one of those tryout days, please reach out to Miss Heidi or Miss Gwen.
This week we are celebrating kindness and inclusion. As a school and a community, there's no place for bullying. Support this cause by participating in any anti-bullying activities during lunch.
High Hopes Huntington North Suicide Prevention Group will meet every Tuesday during study hall in room 203. All previous members of Sources of Strength and all students interested in the mental health of students are welcome to attend.
As many of us remember, before fall break, we had a remote learning day due to a threat made on social media.
Administration takes such threats very seriously, so we thought it might be a good time to refresh our memories on the expected protocols within the building.
I'm Madison Hawkins, and due to the situation about 2 weeks ago, we decided it would be relevant to discuss safety protocols and how to keep you and your peers safe at Huntington North.
Hello, Viking students. It's great to be with you today, and I hope you've all had a great fall break, because I'm guessing this show will air after fall break. Was asked to just speak briefly to the crew on our recent, what we call the Alice drill, and why we did it the way that we did, first of all. Obviously, with what we went through in closing school and schools all across the state, really in the month of September, we're dealing with some threats that were very substantial and some threats that were fabricated and meant to cause chaos and confusion. And with all that we were going through, we did elect, with the juniors and seniors anyway, like a family meeting where you sit down at the kitchen table and you hash out what you're dealing with. It's meant to be taken seriously. The connected nature of the world today, how whether we like it or not, we are all in this together. Anyone can have the platform of the world at any time, and you all know how things can go viral, how you can become an instant celebrity, or how you can instantly send the world into panic is what we learned in the month of September. So we want you as students to continue to report things to us. Don't fear if you have a real substantial threat. We need to know that. And what I'll tell you as students, the importance of how you handle that, okay? If it is some really heavy, serious information, you need to immediately tell the nearest adult to you, the nearest school official, and get them involved. Don't walk away and go home and then blast it out on social media. That's not a good first move. I get what you're doing. I understand that you think you're doing the noble thing, but you got to get it into hands of people who can help the situation first. That should be your first move, just advising you as young adults. So. We do want to spend some time looking at what steps we take as a school in an Alice drill should a situation occur, but we need to spend equally as much time, if not more time, talking about how connected we are before this, how we can really get help to those who need it, and what are good steps, good responsible steps to take as a citizen. And you guys are young adults. You're at that phase of your life where you need to start processing some of this stuff. And I know that you will, and I know you'll handle it well. So I hope that gives a quick follow-up to why we did what we did in the auditorium. All in all, I appreciate the attention of our student body and how they handled that. Those tough conversations, I thought, pretty professionally as a whole. So thank you.
Thanks for the update, Mr. Hamill. A representative from Indiana Tech will be in the cafeteria during lunch on Thursday, October 17th.
A representative from Ball State will be in the cafeteria during lunch on Monday, October 21st.
Walkaway meets every Tuesday after school in the locker lunch. Walkaway is a walking group that welcomes all students to be more physically and mentally healthy by making a habit of walking daily. Any student is welcome to join.
Speaking of being active, let's go to Ben and Cohen with sports.
Thanks, guys. The football team split a pair of games over fall break. The Vikings fell on the road at Leo 34-20 2 weeks ago, but they rebounded at home last Friday, defeating Norwell 49-10.
The Vikings will look to close out the regular season with a win this Friday, hosting New Haven. Kickoff is set for 7 p.m.
The sectional draw for football was Sunday. The Vikings will host Frankfurt in the opening game. If they win the first round, they'll move on to host Marion the following week.
We'll have a deeper look at the Vikes postseason next week.
The girls' soccer team's season came to an end last week as the Vikings fell to Columbia City 6-1 at Homestead. Libby Couch scored the Vikings' lone goal off an assist from Hayden Miller. The team finished the year with a record of 3-12-2.
The boys' soccer team's season also came to an end as the Vikings were shut out by Columbia City 2-0. Peyton Blair tallied 11 saves on the goal for the Vikes, who finished the season with a record of 4-11-2.
The cross-country teams ran in the Northeastern 8 conference meet just over a week ago at Columbia City. The girls' team placed third, while the boys placed eighth. Both teams will open postseason action Saturday at Manchester Sectional.
Finally, the boys' tennis team season came to an end as the Vikes fell to Mississinewa 4-1 in the sectionals final.
The Vikings' number one doubles team of Eli Carter and Isaac Grogg advanced to the regional on Thursday. They fell to Peru's top doubles team in straight sets.
That's it for sports this week. Let's go back to the desk.
Thanks, guys. You know, not all competitors here at H&HS are athletes.
That's right, Sydney. Members of our Quiz Bowl team focus more on brains than brawn. Let's go take a look.
I'm Jeremiah Rozier, and today we're going to be getting some information about Quiz Bowl from Mr. Petrovich.
Quiz Bowl is an academic buzzer-based trivia competition. So if you've ever seen the TV show Jeopardy, it's kind of like that, but played in teams. The team here at Huntington North High School competes against other high schools in our region and across Indiana. We have two kinds of competitions. We play in a conference called the Quad County Conference, which is based in Marion. And then we also play in the wider Indiana circuit on weekend tournaments at places like Purdue and Notre Dame. We have practices on Tuesdays and Thursdays from 3 o'clock to 5 o'clock, and we also host an optional practice during homeroom on Wednesdays. Anybody is more than welcome to attend. It's free to play. You are more than welcome to participate as much as you want. You can just come and hang out and play trivia with us, or you can get involved in our tournaments. We're planning on going to the national championship this year in Atlanta, Georgia. We'd love to have everybody come out and keep playing. We've been practicing since about the second week of August, but anybody's more than happy to come by.
Thank you, Mr. Petrovich. Let's head back to the desk.
That's all we have for you this week.
Have a great week, Vikings, and you'll see us next week.
I am not okay. I'm barely getting by. I'm losing track of days, losing sleep at night. I am not okay. I'm hanging on the rails. So if I say I'm fine, just know I'm